We are recording tonight, so keep your conversation afterwards unless you're one of the candidates speaking.
Where's his wife? Oh, there she is.
I don't know him.
Sure, you say that now.
You wore the green shirt to hide behind the green.
Are you gonna raise your hand when you're ready?
Yeah, now.
Now? Okay. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Hazel Gibson from the League of Women Voters of Greeley Well County, and I have my associates Ann Cummings, Sandy Ward, and Jane Patterson, who these two ladies are from Johnstown and came over to see what's happening here. And Ann is from Greeley. They have collected your cards. Once again, thank you to Mary Lee and those of you who planned this meeting and prepared the refreshments, which if you didn't get them, you can get them after the meeting and talk more with the candidates. I wanted to read the League mission because this is part of the reason that we are invited, not that we look wonderful or look smart or act smart or whatever. But the League of Women Voters is a political organization of men and women that encourages informed and active participation in government, works to increase understanding of major public policy issues, and influences public policy through education and advocacy. The League does not support or endorse any candidate or political party, and that tells you that tonight I'm not favoring one over the other. We're not deciding who's the best, but here's a quick outline. As you know, the election will be April 3rd, where you will elect a mayor and four trustees. Tonight we have five running for the trustee office. Each candidate will have 3 minutes for an introduction to talk about why they want to be elected, why they think they're the best candidate. And we have timekeepers right here that will hold up the paddles to show you where you are, and stop means stop. Then after each of the candidates have introduced themselves, then we will have 1 minute question and answers from these cards. Each candidate will get one question, and then depending on how much time, and they will have 1 minute to answer one question. And then if we have time, we'll go for round two and have another question for each of the candidates. The trustees will be first tonight. I don't know why, I just did. And I had chosen them alphabetically ordered, but I know one of the trustees has to leave early, so I beg your pardon. I know that Leggett does not come first in the pecking order of last names, but Harold Leggett will take the first 3 minutes to introduce himself. So you're on. 3 minutes.
Oh, I was kind of asked to throw my hat in the ring. My expertise is in potable water. I've been dealing with potable water for over 40 years now. I understand I've learned a lot of problems the cities have, and would like to help them resolve some of them and work towards a better future for Plantville. That's my warning. I got to go to another board meeting. I don't have much else to say. I'm willing to help out in any way I can for the town.
Okay. Thank you. So just slip out whenever you have to go. We'll totally understand. actually was, do you need to leave this very minute?
No.
Okay. So I will give you the 1 minute question that you would have gotten if you were going to stay here.
Okay.
The question is, how do we create more opportunities for youth in the community?
You know, you could have asked me that 30 years ago. I could have given you lots of answers. I've been kind of out of the youth programs other than my kids. Is something I've just kind of put on my back burners, and I don't have an idea on that. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry.
Okay. So next in alphabetical order by last name is Spencer Bradman.
Hello, thank you guys for coming. My name's Spencer Bradman. I live on the corner of Elizabeth and Liberty Street, and we've been there since February of last year. My wife, Allie, and my two daughters, Mallory and Emma, are around the corner playing, but we moved here. We actually originally hailed from Northeast Ohio. We came to Colorado in 2015, and I started attending the board meetings about 6 months ago, just because I had an interest in what was going on in the town, and at the time, there wasn't much attendance. And I've always had an interest in government, even since I was a young kid, whether it be national, local, state, I try to stay abreast of most issues that are going on in that realm. And we started going to Rocky Mountain Christian Church in 2016, and that's kind of changed my heart, where I want to serve the community somehow, and I thought that combining my interest in government with my heart to serve, being a trustee would be a good place to start and, you know, make an impact in the community. So that's where my trustee bid comes from. I think I would be a good asset to the town, and I am a fairly newcomer, but in this instance I think that is a positive, because I can work with fellow board members and anyone in the town, and have used it objectively. I don't have any predisposed opinions on anyone based on how they acted 5 years ago in a situation. I'm going to go into every situation with the best interests of Platteville citizens in the town as the number one thing, and I try to stay out of the drama as much as I can. A few ideas I have for the town, just real quick. I do think that working towards developing something for the youth to do in town is good. We've taken care of the senior center. We're still working on the senior center. I want to see that finished. We did a veterans memorial, but now I think we've come around and it's time for the youth to get something in the town. I don't know what that looks like, a splash pad, another activity area, whatever the case may be, but I'm open and willing to accept any comments on that and look for solutions to how we move forward. We also have a large issue in the town currently with a sewer. The town failed a set of regulations that the state has mandated for our wastewater, and we're currently looking at building a new infrastructure for that. So I'm doing plenty of research on wastewater treatment, and I look forward to helping the town with that. Thank you guys very much.
So our next candidate is Larry Clark.
He's incognito.
Good evening. Nice to see so many people turn out tonight, and thank you all. My wife and I, Missy, moved to Platteville about 8 years ago. As I plan on living here the rest of my life, let's put it that way. About 2 years ago, I started going to the board meetings pretty regularly, I'd say. And a year ago, when there was a vacancy as a result of a resignation, the board solicited applications and I applied and was voted in to serve until this next election. So in the 2 years that I've been there, watched a lot, well, I've been through the twice the budget study sessions, try to familiarize myself with what makes this town tick and who makes it tick. Dave Brandt at the Public Works was nice enough to give me a tour of the sewer lagoon, and which isn't, I wasn't scouting out a picnic site. But I wanted to know how it worked, because I kept on seeing these bills that went through for maintenance, aerators and the like. Dave was gracious enough to give me a tour, not only of the lagoon, but the pump stations in town, the infrastructure that makes it all work. What I've come to realize is there's a lot to learn about being a trustee on this board. A lot of particulars, a lot of moving parts, a lot of pieces. But the biggest thing I think the town is faced with is that inconsistent revenue. Because so much of the property tax is based on the oil and gas business, which, as we all know, is cyclical at best. But the revenue is hard to predict and makes it a real balancing act between when you have to decide between wants and needs. And that probably is the most challenging part of being a trustee, is answering to the citizens as to their wants and balancing that with the budget and the capability to address the needs that are there. That's pretty much all I want to say for that. But thank you.
Thank you.
Well said, Bert. Now they know I'm not a politician.
Thank you.
It's nice to meet you. So our next candidate is Nick Ralston.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Nick Ralston. Nicholas, but everybody call for Nick. Born and raised native Colorado in Bennett. I remember playing in Platteville through high school sports and stuff. Moved to Platteville about 5 years ago. I've been working with the railroad for about 20 years now. I lived in Minnesota for a year, but it got too cold, so I came back. I do like this community. I was raised in a small farm town similar to Platteville, and the smaller community kind of sits me a lot better. I lived in Aurora for a little while, and it was good when you're young, but not a place to raise a family. So I intend on running for the Board of Trustees to help out with fiscal and financial issues we're having with the sewer lagoon, and also help out with the community decisions. I think I can make good decisions. I've got a family of five. What else? Kind of stumbled on there. Not as well spoken as some others. But still have leadership skills. Make good decisions there with financial issues in my own household, which would be similar to what, you know, a family or community this size would be beneficial upon. Have been a supervisor there for the railroad and making business decisions for finances, budget, stuff like that. So I do have a little bit of background there with that. My hobbies are motocross and taking care of my kids and camping. Do like hanging out with people, so I want to get a little bit more involved with the community. And I thought this would be a good fit there to help out as well as serve people and get out to meet everybody. Nah, that's about it.
And our last trustee candidate is Penny Salazar.
And y'all know how long 3 minutes is now, right?
I'm Penny, and I have lived in or near the town of Platteville for just about 40 years. I'm a wife, a mom, a grandma, a great-grandma, and I just like to serve. I just like to be involved and help out where I can help out. And when I saw that there were going to be four vacancies on the board, I wasn't sure enough people were going to run, so, because sometimes that's a problem. And so I have previously served on the board. I have helped out with youth functions in town. I've been a t-ball coach, a softball coach, a volleyball coach, worked on the Veterans Memorial Committee, and just like to be involved. I think we're facing some unique challenges coming up for the town with, you know, what we're going to do with the sewage lagoon and looking at additional sources of revenue. I think is going to be real important, and I don't mind taking those things on and helping to try and figure out what's the best possible way to address those issues. I have. In the time that I served on the board before, it was a real learning experience. I encourage everybody and anybody to take it on sometime. Learned a lot, really enjoyed it, and would look forward to being in that position again.
Thank you. So I think you have met the trustees, and we'll let them answer questions shortly. But I will now move to the mayoral candidates, and I have a note from Mayor Steve Nelson, which I will read to you. Due to necessities of my business, I will not be able to attend the March 14th meet and greet. This is my busiest time of year. I apologize for this inconvenience. However, I will be out of state on a business trip this week. Any voters are welcome to call me on my cell phone with any questions and or comments. So I have that cell phone. If you need it after the meeting, you can come get that. If you have questions for him, he would be happy to hear from you. The second, the other candidate for mayor is Andrea Sandoval. You have 3 minutes.
I'm Adrienne Sandoval. I have six generations here in town, or come from six generations here in town. I have five generations in Mead, and so always between the two towns, and it's been very important to me to be have raised my our children here. My husband and I. Yes. Fail. Okay. So, 4 years ago, Steve Nelson asked me to run for the Board of Trustees, and I thought, why not? And I got involved, and I absolutely love it. I want to do more. I own a small business. I run and manage another business. I keep books for two other companies. I am involved and help my grandmother medically, and I've ran the Harvest Days or chaired the Harvest Days for the last 3 years, and am involved and support my children in their youth activities. I'm very busy, got lots going on. However, I have consulted with all of my obligations, and everyone I've met been met with great support. And they all support me in making this mayoral campaign a second priority to my family. My family is always gonna come number one. Let's see, a few things I would like to do in town. If I was elected, I would like to definitely start committees. Committees are very important to me. Committees such as parks and finance and business. We all need to work together and get more people such as yourself involved. And when we have more involvement, then we have accountability. We have a lot more trust. We have more ideas. And so on and so forth. I think that cannot do a disservice to us at all. They don't need to be anything formal. We can meet in parks or local restaurants in town. I would like to focus on responsible growth. In October, a couple trustees and myself were at the town and county dinner, and Platteville is one of three towns in Weld County that is not growing. And I firmly believe that if we're not growing, we're dying. That's very important to me. But responsible growth. I don't want it to just explode. I'd like to foster partnerships. We have businesses, we have clubs, we have churches, other organizations, fire, library in town, and we can all benefit if we work together. And all of those ideas will help us better make decisions on a board so that we can lead and decide on really important things such as sewer lagoons and the other ideas that these lovely people have talked about. I'd really appreciate your vote, and I look forward to, I want to thank you for the 4 years that I have been on the board, and I look forward to the opportunity.
So now I have a handful of questions. If you didn't get your question up to me, raise your hand and one of our workers will come pick that up, our volunteers. We are going to start at the end of the alphabet now, backwards, instead of giving somebody the first choice. So Ms. Sandoval, it's you're up for this first question. Please share your thoughts, and you have 1 minute to respond. Please share your thoughts on what innovative projects would enhance our community.
I've been a part of with the elementary working on a youth coalition. We have a youth coalition in town. I think that if we build that youth coalition and we get our youth involved, they're our future. If that's not going to hurt us by any means. They're going to be more invested in town. They'll be involved. They're simple-minded, and I absolutely love it. They have absolute wonderful ideas that I think we can build on. I think that's important.
Thank you. So, Penny, you're up next. Ms. Salazar. Considering public funds were used to build a senior center, will the facility be used for other appropriate adult uses, like club meetings, etc.? And the same question goes for the senior van.
What I know of that facility now is, yes, there were public funds used to help build that facility. At the last board meeting that I attended, there was a beginning discussion about what a use agreement would look like with the seniors. I think there is opportunity there for other groups within the community to utilize that space as well. It's not the type of environment that you want to turn kids loose in, probably, but I think for other adult-type functions, I don't see that there would be any problem with others being able to use that facility as well. As far as the van, I am not up to speed on exactly where the funds are coming from for that van purchase, so I don't feel confident in speaking to that. If public funds are used, then I would feel the same way about that as well, that when the seniors aren't using it, there might be opportunities for other groups to use it as well.
Thank you. So, Nick Wells. My concern is recycling. What's your position?
I always feel it's good to recycle. I mean, it saves waste there in the trash heaps. You can always reuse the material for other products. It's economical and also resourceful. Keep the streets clean. And really too much else to explain on recycling. Getting trash companies set up there with that. I know in the past there with talking conversations, it's a little pricey, depending on the budget. I know it will be subjected to the trash company and people if they're willing to pay up the extra money there for recycling things or recycling bins or whatnot. They would be, I think, would be acceptable.
What is your vision of growth in the town?
What is my mission?
Vision.
Oh, vision, I'm sorry.
Yeah. How do you envision growth?
Well, first of all, it's necessary for the town to have some growth. I know from the debates that have been going on, there are a lot of varied opinions about how fast, how much, how fast. Where, but if the town is going to survive in a long-term environment, 20, 30 years out, it's going to have to grow to some degree. there's still the opportunity for the board, town, citizens to have the input as to where and how much. Given that guidance, I think that there's no question that it has to happen.
Your opinion of having a marijuana dispensary in Platteville city limits?
Well, my personal opinion, I would support it, but it's not something that I'm going to be actively pursuing unless it is something that the citizens want. I do know that the board will place a moratorium on that sort of business a few years ago. I've done a little bit of research into this subject, and 1 minute may not be enough, but the city of Garden City is the closest city that has marijuana dispensaries. Last year, they received $1.2 million from marijuana alone for their revenue. Most of that came through sales tax. And to say Platteville doesn't want or need any money, I think that's a misstatement. As far as crime goes, I know that's another concern. As far as who I spoke with in Garden City, the town administrator, she said there has been no increase in crime since that. But I think it would be worth a study. It's certainly not something I want to die on, but if the town needs money, we want to build things, I see that as a way to get that money without having to raise our taxes or pursue other things. So that's where I stand.
So this will be round two. We have a few minutes. Because everybody's been on tack and following the procedure. So these are 1 minute again. So again, this will be yours, Spencer. And it's somewhat related. As you know, our town lacks many retail resources. How can you help bring new business, such as pharmacy, to town?
Well, this is a good question. And it goes back to what we were talking about with growth. I do think that it's, in order to attract businesses to the town, we have to have a smart growth plan in place. We only have 900 households currently in Platteville. It makes it tough to support a business on that amount of households. Last year, we added no homes to Platteville, and we're on track to do the same this year. Weld County was the fourth largest growing county in the country last year, and we didn't add one house. I kind of view that as a problem. But I also understand that we want limited growth. So I'd like to find a way that we can bring in new businesses, bring in some residential, but still keep the small town feel of Platteville, because that's why I moved here.
So Larry Clark. The road that runs along Rogers Farm on the east side, what are all the big heavy trucks? They are noisy and pollute the area and wreck a good road.
I don't know, has that road been determined to be a truck route? Mm-hmm. I don't know. I'm really not familiar with it. I really don't know what to say about that. It's something we certainly would take into consideration as a board. I know that there have been other issues brought before the board that have been moved on positively. But I'm not familiar with it, to be honest with you.
Thank you. Mr. Leggett? How's what? Nick Ralston. How important are parks and trails to the town of Platteville?
I would say extremely important. Not enough to put us in a budget crisis, but something to look forward at promoting building our infrastructure of the existing roads and sidewalks. You're talking bike paths as well, right? You say?
Trails.
Parks and trails. So, I mean, get people more involved getting out in the community. I think it's a good way of getting people out, a little bit more exercise. Some of the inner city streets are not in the greatest condition, but what board meetings I've been to, we've been trying to work on those. Saving the money, but I think it would be a good addition to Platteville. Get more bike trails and getting kind of up to speed with a common interest with communities around us and what people are likely to do.
So we're now to Salazar. Is it your turn?
Sure.
Ms. Salazar, how are we doing with the balance of infrastructure improvements and controlling borrowing costs?
I think we're doing amazing well. We have a town administrator that works extremely hard to make sure that our infrastructure is supported, that we have the funds in place to do what needs to be done, and I can't say enough about the job that he does to make sure that our infrastructure is strong, that we do not go into debt. I think we're in a pretty good place right now, but you know, any infrastructure that you have, the cost of just maintaining that infrastructure continues to increase. So we have to get creative about how we're going to bring additional revenue streams to the town to support that.
Thank you. So I think that's, we have one more question. So this will give you an idea of how you're going to weigh in as a board, if you're elected, excuse me, mayor, candidate, but that you'll be part of the conversation. So I'm going to just start right here with Spencer, and each of you will weigh in on the same question that was just handed to me. So you'll just have 1 minute to weigh in, and somebody else can react to the first question, you know, the answer or whatever, as if you were trustees and mayor meet in a mayor meeting, 1 minute per person. So Spencer, when is the board going to fix Reynolds Boulevard? This has been talked about for a long time. It's time for action.
First off, I would agree with that. You know, I've only lived in the town for a year, so it hasn't been a plate of mine for as long as it has for most of you. But I have been in this had discussions with multiple people at this table, as well as our town manager and public works director about that project. The issue is the drainage. So if we were to pave the road currently without adding drainage, and most of you guys know that live in that area, when it rains real hard, you get puddles, standing water. If we build a road with standing water, it's just going to wash out. It's not going to last as long as the money we're going to put into building. So money needs to be found to do it right, to do the drainage and build the road. I know that our town manager, Mr. Rankin, has been trying to secure a grant, some sort of funding for that, and we will continue to do that. But the cost of the project is about as much as the yearly budget of Platteville in total. So we do need to get creative with this to make it happen. But it's certainly something I would like to get done.
Mr. Ralston?
I agree that I've brought that up a few times here before about when it was going to get done or if that had any plans. I would preferably have it on the top of the agenda, get done. I know Mr. Rinkin has done a great job on budget. We're limited to how much funds we can have in that, but getting a plan together to at least start partying peace this year or in the next few years consecutively to get it paved and drainage done would be a top priority of mine.
Sandoval?
Yeah, it's very important. It's going to cost a lot of money, and it's going to take some innovative ideas and involvement with the community. I mean, we've all got our own ideas. You guys have ideas. I think together we can bring them all together, and I think we can make something happen. I'm optimistic with it. It's gonna cost a lot of money. Grants, there's other ideas and phases and different things we need to be open-minded to look at to get this problem handled.
Thank you. Ms. Salazar.
I've seen that road be that way for about 40 years. So I'm very used to that road being that way. It is a huge project. It's just a bad spot out there. and it will take a considerable amount of money to fix it. So, like Adrian said, I think we're going to have to get a little creative and, you know, is it a short-term loan? I don't know what it is, but I think that as a board member, I would be open-minded to hear ideas, to look at ideas that maybe are a little untraditional and see what we can do to get it fixed. But it is going to be a very, very costly project. Thank you. Mr. Clark?
First of all, rentals would be a perfect addition to the town because it leads to the ballpark, mm-hmm. the senior center. It would really enhance the town. As some of the other members have spoken to the cost, I've seen the engineer, heard the preliminary engineering reports. One of the biggest problems is, if I'm not mistaken, right where Division intersects Reynolds is the high point of the road. So currently the water drains both ways, which can't be part of the answer. There's gonna have to be a pump system to get the water from one side to the other so that it all drains in the same direction, which is part of the cost that people are talking about. But it would really be a great enhancement to the town. Again, it's separating out needs from wants again.
I have one question on that, so everyone can, I know you're not doing Q&A, but so everyone understands, do you guys even budget it out to have an idea how much it's going to cost? Because,
yes.
Curiosity, how much?
$1.5 million, right?
So there's, yeah, so that's the issue of why. Thank you. Sorry.
That's okay. So now, if we can take a couple more minutes for closing. You'll have 1 minute, Mr. Clark, to close and say anything new. Repeat whatever you said, why you want to be a candidate, why you're the best. And we'll just ask each candidate to have a closing.
Good. I've enjoyed my time on the board. I truly have. I enjoy doing it. And I was thinking about the election back in February. A wise person that I know, because I was trying to decide whether I wanted to run or not. He asked me, do you like doing it? Do you like being on the board? When I went home and thought about it, it was easy to make my decision from that point. The board takes up serious issues, and they need to be considered by serious-minded people that are able to build a consensus. I've enjoyed doing that, and I look forward to doing it for another either 2 or 4 years, depending on how the election works out. Thank you.
We go south, okay? All right.
I can't tell you that I'm any better than any of the rest of these folks. I think everybody brings a unique position to the table. I can tell you that I'm dedicated when I take something on. I'm not afraid to take on projects that maybe aren't as popular. I stay with them and I work on them until they get done. And that's what I would bring to the table. I'm open-minded. I don't maintain the status quo just because it's always been done that way. In fact, that's one of the things I dislike very greatly. I think sometimes you gotta kick the dust off and explore something new. So.
Thank you. So I've always, a lot of people who know me know that I say this often, I wanna be the change I wanna see in the world. I don't like agendas and politics. Yes, I'm standing here. But I truly believe that if we can come together, open-minded, willing to work together, we can get so much more accomplished. And I think that is absolutely what is key with everything we're facing in this town, be it good or a mountain, you know? I'm not gonna say bad, because it's not bad. It's just an elephant, so. Mm-hmm.
Mr. Wellington?
I'm a problem solver. I'm driven
to find solutions for problems. I plan on raising my family here in this town, so I don't want it to go down the toilet, so I think I'd like to participate. I know I'd like to participate in helping this community thrive. I have good values, and I think I can bring good decisions and good ideas to the table for problems that could be solved. I am creative and I think outside the box, so I'm not narrow-minded to where I can just think of one thing and one solution only. Kind of look around and see what other people have ideas, talk to the community, and see what else anybody else, and maybe not on the board, show up to the state, show up to the briefings there, and give your 2 cents. I'm gonna leave that open. But communication and community involvement are big things, and that's why I want to be on the board.
Mr. Brandon.
Well, I just want to thank everyone for coming, first off. It's been a very good experience, even if I don't get one vote. I'm glad that I ran just to get to meet everyone here, get a little involvement in the community, get to know some new faces. I do think I have a lot to offer to the community. I'm willing to learn anything. I love reading and learning about new things, and especially anything that's mechanical, like a sewer lagoon or a water system. Another thing I wanted to speak on that we didn't talk about too much is access to the river. The town is named after the Platte River, yet I cannot go to the river in Platteville currently. I don't know what that looks like. There is some land available that was set for some developers in the past that's not going to be used. It does have some river access, and I know Mr. Rankin and I have had conversations on this issue. It is in the works. You know, it may not look like it now, but there are at least ideas on that. So I appreciate you guys coming, and I look forward to any questions you might have. My door is always open. Email me, call me. Thank you very much.
So let's hear it for the candidates. So this ends our conversation with the candidates. Thank you again for sharing in this event. Remember, the town holds a municipal election to elect mayor and members of the board of trustees, that's 4, on the first Tuesday of April, April 3rd? The town hall will serve as the polling place for this election, and there have been circulated a couple sample ballots if anybody needs to see those. The polls will be open from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. on April the 3rd. If you have changed your address, changed your name, you need to go back to the website and change your voter registration so that you can vote. If you just turned 16, you can register to vote. You still can't vote till you're 18. But the website is here on these little cards if you want to take one home with you. It's very easy to change your voter registration or actually register to begin with. It's govotecolorado.com. And these are more informational cards, brochures about who we are as the League of Women Voters. We thank you again for the invitation. Thanks to those who made this possible. Thank you. And stick around, talk to the candidates, go have some more refreshments, enjoy the library, enjoy this beautiful evening, and thank you once again.
Thank you.